Today, we are releasing ratings for 18 mid-sized SUVs that have been subjected to our new, tougher side crash test. Our original side crash test was introduced almost 20 years ago. We needed a new, tougher test that represented the real-world crashes that are occurring today that involve higher speeds and heavier vehicles. What we have done is develop a heavier barrier and are now running our tests at a higher speed. Those two factors combined create 82% more energy in our tests today. Overall, this group of vehicles performed reasonably well. 10 of the 18 vehicles received a good rating, 2 more of the vehicles received an acceptable rating, and we had no vehicles that received an overall poor rating. The top performers in this test group were the Mazda CX-9 and the Volkswagen ID.4. They achieved good ratings in all metrics. Close behind were the Ford Explorer and the Lincoln Aviator. The Volkswagen ID.4 was the only electric vehicle that we included in this group of mid-size SUVs, and it performed extremely well. It got good ratings across the board in all metrics. You can see here there was very little intrusion into the occupant compartment, and so the driver and the rear seat passenger were well protected. The injury measures from the dummy showed that there was very low likelihood of injury, and the airbags did a good job of protecting the heads of the dummies. The Jeep Wrangler is missing an important piece of safety equipment when it comes to side impact crashes. Currently, the vehicle is not designed to have an airbag for those sitting in the rear seat, resulting in significant injury. We've downgraded it to a marginal rating overall. The Nissan Murano was one of our worst performers in this group of mid-size SUVs that we tested. It received a poor rating for the structure. That's because of the significant amount of intrusion into the occupant compartment. That also resulted in a higher likelihood of both chest injury and pelvis injury for the driver. The Kia Telluride and the Hyundai Palisade also did not perform well structurally. Both received a marginal rating for structure. They also received a poor rating for driver pelvis injury. Consumers shopping for a mid-size SUV and searching for the highest level of side crash protection have choices among the 2022 models that are available today, with more than half of the vehicles receiving a good rating in our new, tougher side crash test.